So hey everyone, a very important story. A person buying Doge when he had about 8k in Doge saw it high, so he happily sold it for a few grand. Today, that would be worth 2.5 million coins, which would be around, I'd say, $500,000. And what we can see so far is not selling is sometimes the best option, not financial advice. What's going on, everyone? Be sure to drop a like. We have so much to talk about today, especially Shiba Inu crypto coin, crypto ship, could be featured on NASCAR driven by Landon Castile if owners of the coin can convince Stephen Ehrich. And if that's true, that would be exciting to see, because this would be the first big major marketing plan. And Stephen Ehrich responded to a Twitter Inc. post calling for Shib Inc. to be featured on NASCAR Xfinity Series sponsored by Voyager. So we saw this some time ago. This is obviously old news, but if this happens, this would bring a lot of new folk in from NASCAR to crypto. Now, the best thing we're going to be seeing in the future is some sort of this kind of Ryoshi Shiba swap hard wallet. So when we all became wealthy, it was the best way to cash out and really use that money in real life. And you can see here, there's a credit card basically, or a bank card. And that would be really exciting to see in the future. Something like SafeMoon has this. And we can see here, Shiba Inu coin, the cryptocurrency you should be watching. Again, we're backed by Yahoo Finance over here. And the biggest, most important thing that you have to know, there's actually a blockchain being made. We're actually developing other projects that will be implemented in our platform and entire project. They're talking about basically from the AMA for bigger projects, bigger than Shiba Swap. So yes, we're building things with our external teams in order to keep improving our current ecosystem, and you will see that result so soon. And I'm guessing in 2021 we're going to be getting much more updates than you might expect, and I'm really excited for that, to be honest, because we have so many things. Seems like the market is finally recovering, and what the most important thing is, Shiba Inu is actually going mainstream. What we need for Shiba Inu is either a lot of utility. As you can see here, they're developing other projects that will be implemented in their platform and entire project overall, and they're expanding their ecosystem, trying to become the next Ethereum. Is it possible? I do think so, and I find it really exciting, to be honest, to see what kind of update we're getting in 2021. Obviously, Shiba Inu has not experienced its full growth yet, and it's going to be growing much more. But let's get into the important news. Coincidence, Bitcoin saw its highs and lows on turnaround Tuesdays in June, and we're seeing those patterns happening again. Bitcoin seals a month of turnaround Tuesdays. Basically, every Tuesday we're seeing a big bump over here. So every Tuesday it seems like to drop a lot and then go, and it could be a big coincidence, but it could actually be, you know, some wild theory here. So this is for any, you know, tech savvy gurus over here that are into trading, and so far we could be seeing every single Tuesday actually going up. Leaning on this, we form a moderately bullish bias. So Bitcoin and Shiba Inu are only going up in the future, and the past 4 weeks have seen the pair deliver either highs or lows within its range on Tuesdays, with the week being no exception. So that's something really interesting. Are big institutions trading on Tuesdays? And that's when SHIB drops and grows as well. Underappreciated Bitcoin landmarks. Bitcoin price action is for many analysts out of step with reality. And, you know, indicators flash oversold for Bitcoin US. The attention is focusing on riddling the market of selling pressure to allow for an organic run up to challenges resistance level. So a lot of Bitcoin is now going to be sold in July. Later in mid-July, we're going to be seeing a big drop, but then after that, we're going to be seeing organic growth from institutions. Right now, maybe the price is a bit pumped. Not for SHIB, for Bitcoin, you know. Bitcoin will probably, and not financial advice, but the analysts are saying Bitcoin will drop down to 20K, 25K, and then we're going to be seeing that big growth we all need. These might not be huge countries, but we think it's watershed in Bitcoin's transition from a speculative instrument to investment-grade asset. So the El Salvador and Paraguay. So not only is El Salvador coming in, but Paraguay also coming in. These two can be the big things we're going to be seeing when we get the next bump. And this is like proof that Bitcoin has actual use cases from just something random that you just put in $50 in back in 2011 and speculate. I think it's much bigger than that. And seeing those for SHIB, at first it's just speculation, and after it's speculation, it's already too high. It's already 10x. And Coinbase actually now offering 4% interest on USDC holdings, which basically means the dollar is by more than 2,500% since it was lower significantly last June, and the exchange increasing interest for USDC. And I think it's pretty important that some people are going to be opening this instead of their savings account, and it's starting the mainstream investing. A Time publication, USDC is the 8th largest cryptocurrency with a market capitalization of more than $25 billion. You basically provide liquidity, and they you basically stake for some sort of, I'm guessing, a savings account. And Coinbase is trying to become the next Amazon, the next eBay of cryptocurrency from what I'm seeing. And that's really exciting to see so far, because they've been doing pretty well, actually. Tether remains the most popular stable coin on crypto market, coming in third with a 62.5 billion market cap. So these are the stable coins. But for SHIB, I think there's still a massive growing potential from what I'm seeing. But another thing is happening, and I'm going to quickly be explaining this because it's really hard to understand, but we're getting an equities basket with the highest correlation and revenue exposure to Bitcoin. So basically, people can now invest kind of in Bitcoin when it's at highest and when it's at lowest. You can invest into these baskets, basically like stocks, and that's the first mainstream thing you can see. So Bitcoin's main concerns for institutional investors are hack, theft, loss, storage, security, or crime. By investing in equities replicating the Bitcoin's performance, investors can achieve diversified asset allocation that was not available before. And that's what I'm really excited about, seeing that maybe investors will now decide to invest into Bitcoin. From what we can see here, that closes the gap between Bitcoin and EU regulation. All you have to know here is that Bitcoin, if it gets accepted by these large institutions, and now this is one step closer, obviously, by the end of 2021, we should be seeing some massive changes. This index is a true bridge between two worlds, and since it closes the track performance of Bitcoin, a diversified basket, and eliminates usual risk like loss or hacking, the index has its own set of advantages in comparison to straight investment in Bitcoin. So they can decide to invest into these kind of baskets instead of Bitcoin so far, from what I'm seeing, and this is going to be happening for SHIB cryptocurrency as well. But Beijing stepping ahead, and after banning all their cryptocurrency, Beijing's rail trans service now accepts digital yuan for subway rides through integration with the Industrial and Commercial Bank of China. So digital yuan is now in full effect, which proves that Bitcoin actually has some utility, some real life use cases. From what we're seeing, they're using on 24 subway lines. I think it's a pretty clear idea that Bitcoin and basically these digital currencies are not going anywhere anymore. There, as of mid-June, Beijing hosts more than 3,000 yuan-enabled ATMs, allowing the public to deposit and withdraw the digital currency. Previously, the Beijing Local Financial Supervision and Administration announced an initiative to distribute 6.2 million digital yuan to Beijing residents. Imagine in the future, you can actually use that to buy SHIB. If you can use SHIB anywhere, if they're turning that into an ecosystem. But that's really exciting to see. Obviously, they're going for their own coin and not Bitcoin, but we're seeing actual adoption happening. In 10 years, Bitcoin will be worth much more than it is today, because Spanish Socialist Workers Party, PEN's public digital currency initiative. So they all want their own digital currencies, but I think Bitcoin is always simply going to be dominating here. At present, it's perfectly feasible that each individual can have his own account with his digital money directly on a central bank. Yet they're actually regulating cryptocurrency as so far, because it seems like too volatile, but there's some proof in actually having that money. So I think there's two options here. Either you have some sort of a stable coin or basically a digital currency, which is always $1 equals $1. And then you have cryptocurrency, which basically means if you buy Bitcoin back in 2011, you would be rich by now. And a privilege for a moment restricted to banks. And, you know, banks, it's all up to banks that they want to use and let people invest into Shiba Inu or not. But we are growing every single day. And I think at some point we'll be seeing major marketing in the future. Hopefully enjoy this quick type of news, but seeing that we're going to be getting a lot more updates for SHIB is something that makes me very happy, and that a lot bigger team is working outside of the main SHIB team. More updates are coming very, very soon, probably sooner than you might expect. And I'm guessing what the team is actually hinting at is that 2021 is not finished yet regarding updates. So be sure to like the video, and I'll keep you updated. See you next time. Thank you so much.